गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू बायोलॉजी क्लासरूम वंस अगेन। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू वॉच द लास्ट वीडियो। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन बायोटिक एंड अबायोटिक फैक्टर्स। सो लुक एट द बुक। ऑल ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड देयर लाइफ प्रोसेस आर ग्रेटली इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय देयर इंटरेक्शन विद अदर लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म एज वेल एज विद बायोटिक अबायोटिक कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट। सो the interaction or interrelationship between the biotic and abiotic components just mix up with each other. An ecosystem is a living system where all organisms live together in a community, abiotic and biotic, and how they connect, interact with each other. So an ecosystem defined as a living system, whereas all organisms live together in a community, and the biotic and abiotic factor, they connect and interact with each other. So what is an ecosystem? Ecosystem is a live system, whereas lots of different types of species live together in a community, and the biotic and abiotic factor, those are interact and connect with each other. It is formed by the interaction between the biotic factors and abiotic factors in a habitat. ये form कैसे करेगा? Because it is a live system, that's why if the species cannot able to habituated in a particular habitat, it is not able to do interact with each other. Some examples of ecosystem include pond ecosystem, forest ecosystem and sea ecosystem. We will discuss about forest ecosystem here. So look at the book. Forest ecosystem. A forest ecosystem consists of the community of plants, animals, microbes and all other organisms in the interaction with the chemical and physical features of their environment. Forest ecosystem includes the biotic components such as the organic and inorganic substances present in the soil and atmosphere. So what is the meaning of particular portion? A forest ecosystem consists of the community of plants, animals and microbes. So whereas plant as a producer, animal as a consumer and a microbes as a decomposer, they all together living in a community and form an ecosystem. Whereas the organism, the biotic components depend upon the abiotic component or interact or connect with the chemical and the physical feature of the environment. So, forest ecosystem includes abiotic component such as organic and inorganic substances that is present in soil and atmosphere. It also includes dead organic debris. Here is taking part basically microbes. Biotic components include trees of different species, shrubs and other ground vegetation. So the biotic components are basically different types of species, shrubs and other ground vegetation. Green plants conducting photosynthesis serve as the producer of the forest ecosystem. So the main producer of the forest ecosystem is green plant. Animals such as ants, beetles, flies, bugs, spiders and the grasshoppers hopping around the trees feed on their leaves. These are called primary consumer. Secondary consumer includes different kinds of birds, snakes, lizard crawling on tree. These secondary consumer mainly feed on this primary consumer or herbivores. The top consumers or tertiary consumer as basically tiger, lion, leopard feed on such animals. So decomposer includes wide variety of microorganism including fungi and bacteria. So basically in a forest ecosystem, such as some ants, butterflies, bugs, spiders, different types of insects, which are basically hopping around the trees, and they ate, basically they eat the green leaves of trees. They are primary consumer. Again, some crawling organism, and especially snake, lizard, different types of reptiles and birds, they intake the primary consumer as their food. They are secondary consumer, and the top consumer are basically tiger, lion, leopard. They eat basically secondary consumer. So same way in this ecosystem, decomposers are basically microorganism which are fungi and bacteria. The decomposers of the forest ecosystem break down dead plants and animals and returning the nutrients to the soil to be made usable by the producers. So basically, what is the role of the decomposers? Decomposers help to decompose the dead and decaying particles which are left on the soil, and they turn them into smaller part of nutrients which mixes with soil, and it is againly usable by the producer. Next, flora and fauna in a forest ecosystem. It is very important. Flora and fauna. Flora means the plants which grow naturally in a particular area. So what is the meaning of the flora? In a particular area, which plants grow automatically. Matlab, we have not to plant them. हम लोगों को ज़रूरत नहीं है उसको प्लांट करने का. तो नॉर्मली जो प्लांट खुद से खुद ब खुद ही एक पर्टिकुलर कोई एरिया में जन्म ले रहा है उसको हम क्या बोलेंगे? फ्लोरा. एंड फौना ऑन द अदर हैंड मीन्स द एनिमल्स लिविंग नेचुरली इन एन एरिया. सो फौना मीन्स एन अ पर्टिकुलर हैबिटेट और कम्युनिटी व्हिच पीसेस आर एबल टू लिव टुगेदर. दे आर बेसिकली फौना इन अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया. There are different types of forest found in the different region of the world. For example, tropical, temporal, boreal, arboreal forest, etc. Therefore, the plants and animals living in forest of cold region will be different from the forest in the warmer region. So the different types of ecosystem are found in the different region. Like cold region ecosystem is rather than different from the warm region ecosystem. Next, role of flora. Plants maintain the natural forest ecosystem. They comprise of a variety of trees, herbs, shrubs, mosses, etc. So all animals directly or indirectly depend on plants for their food. For example, herbivores eat plants. Carnivores and omnivores feed on the herbivores. So plants directly or indirectly provide food to all the organisms. So what is the main role of flora? Flora basically is the green plants which are able to give birth automatically. We have not to plant them. So they are flora. So same way, they are the main producers of the particular ecosystem. So same way, primary consumers eat the green grass or flora. Again, secondary consumers and the tertiary consumers eat up the primary consumers. So directly or indirectly, the energy or food basically which is produced by green plants, it is provided from one organism to other organism. The plants take in carbon dioxide for photosynthesis and give out oxygen in the atmosphere. So animals take in this oxygen while breathing. So in this process, basically green plants release oxygen with the help of photosynthesis process, and the all organisms or living organism intake the oxygen and release the carbon dioxide in the breathing process. So many animals such as us monkeys and birds depend on plants for shelter. Some animals make holes in the trees and live there. Birds build their nests on trees. There are a number of insects such as the live on the grasshopper, moths and ants that live on the trees. So here is that trees are very important. Not as us producers. Basically trees are basically shelter. I mean forest is a shelter of different types of animals such as monkey and birds. They able to build their nest on the tree. Same way birds, different types of insects, they can easily live on the trees. Next, role of fauna. Animals play an important role in the maintaining the ecosystem in a forest. Animals take in oxygen and release carbon dioxide while breathing. This carbon dioxide in turn is utilized by the plants in the process of photosynthesis and oxygen is released. So what is the main role of fauna? So in a particular area which living organism live, they easily release the carbon dioxide in the breathing process, and same way the carbon dioxide is absorbed by the green plants to make their food by the process of photosynthesis, and they again release oxygen. In this way, the oxygen level is maintained by the atmosphere of the maintained in the atmosphere by the green trees. So student, I hope all of you have understood what I have discussed today. So for today, up to this portion.